Good afternoon, students. How are you all? Are you all keeping fine? So, students, in the last class, we are discussing about chapter 12, growing plants. Isn't it? We are discussing about chapter 12, growing plants. So this is the topic we are discussing. Okay. So students, we have completed the in this chapter we have completed the two topics, that was the reproduction in plants. Then the second was new plants from seed. How we get the new plants from seed, that we have discussed. And number third, the third topic we were trying to understand, that is structure of seed. This was the topic we were trying to understand, the structure of seed. So students, as we know, the structure of seed, if I make a simple seed, let us make it. Okay. We divide it from here. So somehow this is seed. This is the seed. Okay. So in the between here, small, what is that? Shoot, baby shoot. This is known as baby shoot. Baby shoot. Okay, this is baby shoot. And then the inner side, that is here, the bottom you will see, that is baby root. Baby root. Okay, this is baby root. Then, what else? Then we see that cotyledon, we see this ball. These both are, so this is this both, these and these. They are known as cotyledon. Cotyledon. Cotyledons. So let us understand. This is the seed. This is which kind of seed? This is the seed of rajma. You can see the seed of rajma. It looks like, or it is the seed of beans. Seed of beans. Okay. So structure of seed. Observe a beans or a gram seed. Gram seed also you can see. You can see the chana. Chana, you know. Then B also. Peas also you can see. So it is hard and cannot be broken easily. This is the seed is very hard. It cannot be broken very easily, as we have already discussed. Okay. So then the hard outer cover is called the seed core. This is outer cover. This is outer cover of the seed. Listen, this is known as seed pod. When we wear the pod, where it is? It is outside our body. It covers our body and it gives us warmth. It protects us from the cold. And during the summer, we wear the t-shirt or shirts. They protect us from the sunlight, or they protect us from the heat. So why we wear? To protect ourselves, our body. Same way, here the seed pod, it protects the body, which is inside the pod. There is seed. There are the, like baby root is there, baby shoot is there, and cotyledon is there. So these are, they are protected by the seed pod. Okay, that is known as seed pod. The seed pod protects the seed. So the work of seed pod is protect the seed. Okay. The The seeds have special seed leaves for cotyledons or cotyledons. Special cotyledons. This is the cotyledon we say it. So cotyledon protects the baby plant or the embryo. It protects the baby plant and the embryo. They also store food for the baby plant. These to the both plants cotyledon. They store the food for baby plant. They store the food for baby plant. Okay. Seeds like grass, beans, and peas have two cotyledons. So this is of two cotyledon. One, then this two. So the rhizome or we can say the grass, or we can say peas, they are having the two cotyledons and many other things. White seed like wheat and corn have only one cotyledon. So like rice, paddy, they are having only one cotyledon. So this is the you can see, we can understand the seed and the parts of the seeds. But the right side of the your book here it is shown the how the scale is called for water. Here if you might have seen the chana or the gram, that is having a tip point. Okay, the small point from where the water is absorbed. If when it is brought or when we buy it from the market, it is very dry and it is solid. We cannot eat is when we want to cook it, what we have to do, we have to pour it into the water for 12 hours or maybe for 24 hours. So that is why that absorbs the water from where the hole for water small. Then seed coat. The seed coat already we have discussed. What is the seed coat? Okay. Then students, we will discuss about the dispersal of seed. Already we have dealt it in the live class. In the live class, we have discussed in the live class that how the dispersal. Dispersal is transfer. As your parents do the government job or central government job, they are transferred from one place to another place. Same way dispersal of seed. Dispersal of seed means we see that mango trees in Goa, we also find the mango tree in Jajpur, we find the mango tree in Bilaspur, we find the mango tree in the Raipur. So these mango trees, in the beginning they may be in one place, but their dispersal has been done with many the ways, or that is transferred from one place to another. How it is? So students, our topic is dispersal of seed. Okay, dispersal of seed. So this is dispersal of seed or transfer of seed. So plants cannot move on their own. Like human beings, we have the two legs. The animals, they have the four legs. They move by their own. We human beings, we move by our own. But the plants, they cannot move by their own. So nature has developed a way to scatter their seeds. So nature has developed the way to scatter their seed in many different ways. The scattering of seeds always from the parent plant is known as dispersal of seed. Suppose here one, let us make a tree of mango. We make the tree of mango. Suppose this is the or this is the tree. And the fruits are there. Okay. This is not mango, this is apple. Okay. So this is apple tree. So when the parent tree, this is parent tree. When the parent tree has got the fruits in it, when it is ripe, it is fallen down on the ground. The ground is fallen down, or someone plucks and eats. Okay, someone plucks and eats. So if the dispersal will be not there, or if the transfer will be not there of the plants or the seeds, then what will happen? We will understand first. Okay, if the mango trees or the apple trees, they have the main fruits are there in this tree. Okay, so when it is fallen down on the ground, what they do? They dry it. And when the monsoon comes, or the heavy rains comes, at that time they get the moisture, they get the water, they get the air, they get the warmth, they get the sunlight. So at that time they start to grow. These the pollen seeds, they start to grow, and when there are number of seeds here, number of seeds under the tree, then in this small area the number of seeds will grow. So what they will face? They will face lots of problem to complete their need, because in the small places they will not get sufficient water, sufficient minerals which they need. In that way they cannot grow properly. That is why we see that under the mango trees or under the apple trees, if it is grown, it doesn't get the proper food. So what it happens? It dies after some time. It dies. So they are fighting for the small in the small fields. In that way, they cannot grow up. The germination has been taken place, but the growth of plant is not there. So dispersal is very important for every tree, every seed. Their dispersal is very important. Okay, so students, as you can see, seeds are dispersed by agents such as wind, water, birds, insects, and animals. These agents are called agents of dispersal. So there are many agents. We, the human beings, are also agents. How are we agents? We are agents in many ways. We buy the mangoes or any other fruits from the market, and we eat it. And then when we throw the seeds outside, then where we have thrown the seeds, there the germination starts, and there can be a mango plant or mango tree or any seeds which we have thrown. So students, one by one you will understand how the these things they help in the dispersal of seed. First, the wind. As we can see in the picture, page number 48, we can see in the picture the wind. How sometimes we have seen the person in the village areas or in the forest areas, you will find that some potents they used to fly in the air. Why? Because it is so lighter than air, so that it starts flying. And when it is flying, you will see under the cotton there is small seed that is also flowing by the wind. And when it stops, that falls down on the ground, and there it starts the germination. When it gets the water, the moisture, it gets the light. In that way, they can be germinated in that area. Okay. So some seeds light and have special tufts of hair and wings that help them to be carried away by the wind from one place to another. For example, cotton, dandelion, and the mother seed have tufts of hair around them. Okay. Then hickory, maple, and sycamore seeds have wings attached to them. Like here you can see in the picture, they are having the wings attached to them. When the air flows, when the wind flows, they are flown with the wind in the some different areas. So this is the wind. How the wind is, and wind helps in dispersal. The second is water. Second is water. How the water helps in dispersal. Suppose if you are near the river, there are many any fruit trees are there. Like it may be the palm tree, it may be the coconut tree, it may be the blackberry tree, whatever. Trees, if the trees are near on the bank of the river, then when they are ripened, they are fallen on the ground or on the water, they are flown with the water away, and in some places where they get the soil, in some areas in the river only they get the soil, so there they start the germination. So the wind, which how the wind helps in dispersal, same way the water also helps in the dispersal of seed. Let us read the paragraph so that we can understand it in more clear ways. Water helps in dispersal of seeds of plants living in water for a place near it. The lotus fruits has a spongy part and the coconut has a thick fibrous coat. These special parts enable the lotus fruits and the coconut to float on water. So when a coconut falls from the tree into water, it floats on water and travels to far places. So that is why we see the coconut in the river of the bank, and at the other end of the river you will see the coconut tree there also. From where it comes from the upper side, and it, by flowing and the floating, it goes there and there they can reach. Okay, number 3, human beings and animals. Number 3, animals. Animals, you know, animals, they are very important in the dispersal of seed. How some of the animals, they go in search of their food. If the they go in search of their food, what happens that the foods, they stuck in their body, in the animal's body. Okay, then when they are moving to the different place, at that time if animal, they sometimes they sit on the ground, so there it may fall, the seeds can be fallen, can fall there, and there they start germination. Okay, so this way the animals also help in germination. And many other animals like birds, what they do, birds, they eat the seed and they take the seed for their younger ones also. When the bird has made the nest, when they have the eggs, or the chickens they have, for them, if they are carrying the some seeds, so on the way also that can be fallen, and because of that the germination takes place there also. So birds also, they are also very important for the dispersal of seed. Then the many animals, like animals eat and throw it, like monkey. Like monkeys, they come and they climb the tree. They want the tree, they are plucking the food and they are eating, and sometimes they throw it away. On that also, it and that generation takes place in the in that area. Or many animals, they eat the fruits or they eat the seed, and if it is not bitten, correctly, not chewed correctly in their mouth, it goes into the stomach, and when they are having the urine, at that time it can germinate there also, in that place also, especially the tomatoes and all those, and it can germinate in that place. Okay, so let us see how the human beings or the animals, they help in the germination. So let us read first, then you can understand it better. Animal seeds are also dispersed by birds, animals and human beings. Okay. Then human beings, how? First, the human beings and animals eat juicy and fresh foods like mango, apple, and watermelon, and throw away their seeds. Good. They throw away their seeds, and when the where the seed is thrown, there it starts the germination and becomes plants. And they become tree. Good. Then number two, seeds of plants like Xanthium, tiger nail, and spear grass are hoops or spines. They stick on the hairy skin of animals, cloth of human, and are carried away. Suppose we have the woolen cloth in the winter season. We are wearing the woolen cloth and we go to play in the ground. Sometimes while playing, we fall down. When we fall down, some seeds that stuck on the our woolen cloth. And when we come back to our home, or after the playing, when we are outside of the ground, what we do? We see that stuck on the our woolen cloth. We throw it. We just shake it so that seed can be fall on the ground. That way also the seed is dispersal. That is also dispersal of seed is done by the human beings and the animals. As I earlier told you, the animal in their body, they stuck the seeds and they go away from the particular place to the different place. So there they take the seeds with their body, and that is the germination is done in the that area also. Number three, some seeds are eaten by birds and animals. These seeds are coated so that they do not get destroyed. So when birds and animals swallow them, they can come out unharmed in their waste, in their waste materials, droppings, that is not droppings. Thus seeds are dispersed to their other places. Thus seeds are dispersed to other places. Then number four, if we will discuss, that is the number four is explosion of fruits. Explosion of fruits. Okay, explosion of fruits. Explosion, how? If the some fruits or some fruits when they are ready for to use. So before that, if it is there only inside the cover, like peas, you might have seen the rajma also, you might have seen the gram also. So what they happen when they are inside, the seeds are inside, when it is dried it is exploded, blast, like cracks the glass, and there the wrappers, they are thrown here and there. Same way these seeds also, like here you will see the pea. Okay, pea pod bursts open when it is dried. This pea is well dried, so these are the explosion is there, the seeds are going in the different places. So that is why the seed explosion also, they also help in the dispersal of seed. So let us read it so that we can understand in more clear way. Some fruits burst open or explode when they become dry. The force of explosion help the seed to scatter away the dispersal of pea. Then juniors and balsam seeds take place by explosion. Some of the fruits are there. Okay, so students, as we are looking about the seeds, we are trying to understand about the dispersal of seeds. In India also,
baby foods were not in India. Okay, like water, like tomato, lady's finger, the vegetables, they are not origin, they are not originated in the India. They are of South Africa. There, in the multiple number, vegetables are grown in the South Africa, like tomato, green chili, then of course the lady finger also. They are specially of the South Africa. When some people maybe they came from that foreign country to our country and they brought it, the seeds they were brought, they brought it here in the India and they start the plantation, or they started the growing same vegetables in India. In that way, these vegetables are transferred from South Africa to India. In same way, many of the areas like in the UP, in the Bihar, in these areas, famous the mangoes, like mango, we say the Dasari aam or Dasari mango, we say. There are the some kinds of mangoes are there. They are very special category. They are grown in this area, UP and Bihar, and in the Chhattisgarh we don't get it. When the transporting is being done, we get from the UP, we get from the Punjab, we get it from the Tamil Nadu, like from Tamil Nadu or Kerala, from the south side we get the coconuts and bananas. Okay, so these are from other states but we are getting it, and from there we have brought the like sprout we have brought, the banana sprout, and we have planted in the Chhattisgarh, and that is here also we cultivate it or we grow the same thing. So students, mainly the human beings, for above the fruits items, then the vegetables item, they are many of the fruits or vegetables, they are brought from the different countries and now they are being grown in the India. So students, the human beings, mainly they play most important role in the dispersal of many seeds. Okay, so today we are ending our class here, where we have understood the dispersal of seed, how it is done. So students, we are completing our one more class. It may take, because the there are two pages are there which we have to complete it, that we will discuss in the next video, but today we are ending our class. Okay, thank you, have a nice day, study well, go growing.